I'm really scared to make this video. Welcome by Retro Machines. My name is Victor Bart.
I have this Olivetti M19 from a dumpster. So in this video I'm gonna try it out to see if it still turns on. But I'm really scared because it's also with a monitor involved. So I hope we don't blow something up.
It was complete like this in a dumpster with the original keyboard and it's really dirty. And here the cable is in this plastic bag because, let me show you why. The cable is totally gone and all the plastic is falling off and it makes this really big mess and this really some air. Let's throw that away. And it's really sticky and gross. Let's first check out the monitor. And as you can see, it's a little bit beaten up. And here we have the dials of the monitor and the power switch. Here on the bottom there's a crack. So I hope it didn't fall or something. And here at the rear we can put in the power plug. And it's an M19 DSM9012. And there are two cables, one for the video signal and one big power cable, because the power supply of the machine is inside of the monitor. Here we have the machine itself, the Olivetti M19 with the keyboard plug and two floppy drives, probably 360 kilobyte, and it says here A and B. Here on the side there's missing a piece and there's some kind of ISA connector here, so probably for an expansion unit. And here at the rear we have a COM port, a parallel port, probably this is the video out. Here goes the power plug from the monitor and here's a switch from 8 MHz to 4.77 MHz. So it's like a turbo button. So this is probably an 8086, but I'm not sure, I didn't look it up. And this is an M19/BU1931 and it is made in Italy. So let's open the machine and inspect the inside of it. And the nice thing about this machine is that this is the oldest machine in the studio. There are some screws also here on the bottom, so let's remove them too. Okay, the front can come off. Okay, yes. Here we have the inside of the case with the two floppy drives, so there's no hard drive in this machine. We have two ISA slots here, but with a low profile variant, and I never seen low profile ISA cards before. Here we have the CPU board, and let me see, there is an Intel 8088 installed. The motherboard is full length, so I'm gonna remove the two floppy drives to inspect the motherboard under it. And I hope there's not a leaking battery yet. I don't see a battery on the motherboard, but here we have a PC speaker. And here on the side you can adjust the volume of the PC speaker, that's really nice. And I found a reset switch here on the side. Here on the keyboard plug there's some kind of white stuff, so I probably need to clean that. In general the motherboard looks really clean and the caps looks okay. So I think this part of the system looks okay enough to try it out. And we can probably disconnect the floppy drives before we gonna put power on it. So if there's an issue with the power, we don't blow up the floppy drives. Here on the CPU board I found a date. It says Olivetti 1986. So this machine is probably from 1986. And also here on the motherboard it says 1986. Here we have the memory, and there are some base memory here on the board and some extra chips installed, and there's even another row for extra memory here. Let's try to power up the system, but first I gonna try only if the monitor still will turn on before connecting it to the system itself. And I have here a power cable. Ah, this is scary. Okay, we have power on the monitor. Okay, no smoke. Let's connect the system to the monitor. First monitor cable. And now this big power plug. So let's see what the orientation is. Okay, it can be only fitted on one way. So let's see if it works. Beep. Hey, yes, it's working. 512 kilobyte RAM, parity not installed, CPU 8088, ROM module pass, all pass. Bootstrap disk read error. Yeah, because the floppy drives are not connected. And the monitor seems also okay, and it is a green CRT. So let's connect the floppy drives. Okay, it's now accessing the floppy drives, but I don't have software to boot it off. Okay, let's put the system back together. It doesn't turn on. Okay, the power plug was fallen out. Okay, the check LEDs of the floppy drives are also working. Oh, we have a memory fail. Let's try to turn it off and on again. Okay, and again the memory fail. That's strange. I don't think I have a boot disk on a 360 kilobyte floppy. So I can't really test the software, but wait, maybe I have something. Let's see. I think I have MS-DOS 5 on floppy, so let's see if it will boot off one of the disks. Disk 1 setup, disk 2, disk 3, disk 4, disk 5. And in the other set there's the same. So let's see if it will boot off a floppy. Illegal interrupt number 018 at an address. Let's see if the reset button works on this system. Okay, that works. There's something wrong with this machine. Okay, the memory fail is now even on 256 kilobyte. So I think I'm gonna send this machine to Dave so he can inspect it, because he has a lot more knowledge about the really old stuff like this, and he has the boot floppies and the right hardware to test out this machine, and he has also probably a replacement cable for this. I think that is the best solution for this machine to get it working again and to get software for it and maybe some games. Because the machine is pretty nice, it's really dirty. The keyboard doesn't feel that great for typing. But the M19 turned on without smoke. The display is nice and clear. So this is a really nice machine and I found it in a dumpster. With the keyboard and the monitor, so as a complete set. And that was really lucky with this system, because the power supply of the system is in the monitor. So without the monitor, it's impossible to use the M19 itself. But I will contact Dave about this machine, so he can take a look on it and get it back up and running again. So, thanks for watching. Please like and share this video, subscribe and leave a comment. You can join Retro Machines on Facebook and support me monthly on Patreon.
This train is inbound from level 3 dormitories to Sector C test labs and control facilities. If your intended destination is a high security area beyond Sector C, you will need to return to the central transit hub in Area 9.